episode 2092, Is Joy Possible Today?
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive by. Happy day, it's Friday. Yay, are you excited? I am ecstatic because I get to enjoy the weekend and so do you. It's football weather. Did you see the moon last night? Oh my gosh, it was absolutely gorgeous. Well, today is Confessions of an Upset Mama, and you know what? We've got a big confession. Is joy possible today? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. This episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, there are many blessings in life, and one is being a parent. But when the tasks wear on you physically and mentally, you begin to wonder, is joy possible today? No one readily admits that they are tired of being a parent. You go up to any parent, they're like, oh, I'm doing great. This is awesome. I wouldn't change anything for the world. But parenting, you know, is not for the faint at heart. You have to be willing to work when you're exhausted, to smile when you're upset, and to play when you wish you could be alone. Where was this in the parenting handbook? No one will tell you until you experience it. No one gives you a clue that this is what real parenting looks like. And then it's just swept underneath the carpet as if it really doesn't happen. The fact is that you do get tired. The fact is you wish you didn't have children. Come on. You've admitted it at least once in your mind, maybe not out loud, but it has happened. I have five. I have admitted that to myself. The fact is, you don't think you're a good parent. The fact is, you don't have all the answers. The fact is, this is life. But in all of these moments, is joy possible today? Yes, oh yes, it is. The joy isn't in what your child does or does not do. The joy isn't in how much you know. The joy isn't about doing everything for your child. The joy is possible today because it's face to face. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy, face to face. You see, joy can't be found in all the stuff of this world. Your child can't earn your love. Your child can't do everything perfect, but we forget where the joy is, face to face. Most of our days are filled with communicating with our children, right? Via electronics, texting. We've got mobile devices like crazy, and that's how we communicate. We see their profile in passing as we drop them off or pick them up from activities. Good night comes with a quick, gotta sleep because it's almost morning. That is reality. Yet it doesn't have to be your reality. Believe it or not, your child wants to see you face to face. And I know you want the same. Think back to when you first laid eyes on your child. Your heart grew 100 times bigger. You never thought you could love more. And yet you do. You are missing the joy because you are missing the faces. When was the last time you spent conversing, looking at each other in the eyes? We don't even look at strangers in their eyes anymore. We can't even look our own family in their eyes because we don't see them. All we see is what? The tops of the heads. And yeah, I don't know about you, but as I get older, it's thinning a little bit. And who wants to see the top of my head anyway? If I don't have my good hair coloring in, oh yeah, you see my little halo wrapped around. I understand that we get busy. I understand that technology has moved us to the point that we don't have to be in communication in the same room. But you see, what we're losing out on is a blessing that God gave us, and that's face to face. I think about how God looks at us as his child. We don't have to earn his love because he gave his son. We don't have to be perfect because he gave his son. All we have to do is to be who he created. He doesn't ask anything more or anything less of us. It's because he created us. It's because he loves us. When we look at our child, when you look at your grandchild, when you look at your niece, your nephew, that love is greater. Not because you were given a perfect child, not because they can do everything right, not because they play in the NFL league, not because they're the doctor, not because they're a lawyer, not because they are a politician up in Washington, D.C., not even because they are the president of the United States. No, you love them because they're yours, your baby, your child. We are missing the joy because we are missing the faces. So when was that last time you spent conversing, looking at each other eye to eye? It's hard to think back to a time for most. And if you can, you probably wish you had more of those. Face-to-face grows your heart fonder. It ignites the connection deeper. It widens the path of understanding and unconditional love. Why weave in and out of your day just settling? Joy can be yours as a parent, even when you don't know what you're doing. And I know for me, there are many days I don't know what I'm doing. I am literally getting by on a wing and a prayer. And I'm like, Lord, if you don't get me through this, I don't know what will, because it's not going to be my brain. Joy can be yours as a parent, even when you don't have the answer. Joy can be yours as a parent, even when you are exhausted. Tune into your child face to face. Be willing to let your heart expand. And hang on, because a few tears might be shed due to the depth of the joy found in your little blessing, a child. And you know what? That little blessing, it can be a big one too. They don't just have to be a baby. You can have a baby at the age of 30. You can have a baby at the age of 50. Your baby has no age, right? They're always your baby regardless of their age. Be the parent who sees your child so you can hear the details and be able to experience the joy regardless of your everyday circumstances. I don't know what your day looks like today. I don't know what your weekend's going to bring. I don't know how you say goodnight or how you greet each other in the morning. But what I do know is that you have a blessing in your presence. It's your child. And if you're blessed with more than one, then it's your children. I want you to be encouraged today not to find happiness in the shortcomings of getting an A on a test. Woohoo! That only lasts so long. I know for us, the quarter is coming to an end. And I'm sitting here thinking, this is awesome. And my son reports to me, Mom, this is where I'm at. And I'm saying, that's great. But you know what? My joy doesn't sit and rest with him and his accomplishments. They don't sit and rest in any of my children. I have joy because of the blessing that they are to me, and to be in their presence. So again, be a parent who sees their child face to face, so you can hear their details and be able to experience the joy regardless of your everyday circumstances. Go out, be present, be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.